Hey guys, welcome to the Catway. So in this video, we are going to solve a LRDI set based on roots and network. Before I begin, I would like to thank all the people who have joined us. Our Facebook group link is there in the description below. Now let's roll in for the video. So the question says that the diagram below shows the roads connecting six cities A through F. However, all the roads in the diagram below were not open for travel at the same time, and any person can travel along any road only when the road is open for travel. The roads AC, AB, BD, CE, and PF were open for travel at beginning of 2011. The roads AD, EF were open for travel at beginning of 2012, and remaining roads were open for travel at the beginning of 2013. So what we can see is this is the for 2013 road structure for 2013 because all the roads are open in 2013. What we have to do is we have to make the roads for 2011 and we have to make the roads for 2012. Okay, so let's do it. So in 2011, what roads are open are, let's check it out. Okay, so the roads which are open are AC. So let's make it A and C. Then we have AB. So we have A and B. After that, we have B and D. Okay, so B and D is also opened. After that, we have B and F opened. And after that, we have C and E also opened. Okay, so these were the roads opened in 2011. In 2012, what happened was two additional roads were opened. So first, we need the basic structure for 2011. After that, only we can add two roads in 2012. So let's make it again D, and this one is F. The two new roads were E2F and A2D. Okay, now we have all the road structures. Now let's move towards the questions. So the question one says that in 2011, in how many ways can a person travel from city A to city F without passing through any city twice? So we have to move from city A to city F. Now we can see to reach city F, there is only one way, that is through city B. Okay. And to reach city B, there are two ways, city D and city A. But can we reach city D from city A? No, we cannot reach. The only way to reach from city B is through city A. Okay. So that is the only possibility when we start from A. So our only route is A, B and F. So this will be your answer, that only one way is there. Okay, one way. So that's your answer. Okay, let's move to question two. The question two says, in 2012, a person traveled from city D to city E. What is the number of cities that he, it's not missed, it's must have passed through. So must have passed through means compulsory, which are necessary to be passed through. Okay, which are the cities? So let's see, from D to E he has to go. So there are three ways. Okay, from D he can move towards B, from B he can move towards F, and from F to E. The other way is he can move from D to B, B to A, and A to C, and then E. Okay, the other way is directly D to A, D to C, and D to E. Okay, now there are three methods. Now which one are we going to count? Again, read the question properly. What is the number of cities that he must have passed through? Okay, so must means will be always the minimum number, because these are the minimum number of cities that he must have passed through. Okay, maximum, whatever is the maximum can be avoided. That route can be avoided, like this route. This route can be avoided by directly going without going from B to A, directly going B to F, or if you have to take A and C, then directly going to A and C is also a possibility. So there are only two cities, either B or F or A or C, which he must have passed through. Okay, so there are only two ways. So your answer will be two ways. So now let's move towards the third question. Acha, what is the difference between number of ways that a person can travel from city A to city F, okay, without passing through any city twice in 2012 and 2011? So in 2012, from A to F, let's see what routes are there. Okay, let's remove this all. From A to F he has to go. Acha, what I do is, see, there can be many number of cases. In 2012 it will be very less number of cases, but in 2013 there will be a higher number of cases, higher number of routes. Okay, so what we are going to do is, what I will do is, see, what are the ways? From A he will start. From A, where can he go? He can go to B. Okay, also from where A he can go to C. Acha, if he goes to C, then he does not have any other option, he will go to E and he will go to F. Okay, they are talking about A to F, A to F. So this is the only possibility. Acha, but if he goes to B, hai na, is there any other possibility? Is there any other possibility? No, there is no possibility. So he will go from A, B, F. अच्छा व्हाट इज द थर्ड वे ही कैन गो टू डी. इफ ही गोज टू डी देन ही हैज वन पॉसिबिलिटी, ही कैन गो टू बी एंड देन ही कैन गो टू एफ. सो द टोटल नंबर ऑफ वेज इन 2012 आर 3. ओके नाउ लेट्स मूव टुवर्ड्स 2013. व्हाट आर द नंबर ऑफ वेज. सो लेट्स कैलकुलेट, लेट्स स्टार्ट कैलकुलेटिंग. सो द फर्स्ट वे वेयर ही कैन गो इज बी. लेट्स से ही वेंट टू बी. ओके सो डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम बी ही कैन गो टू एफ. दैट इज वन पॉसिबल केस. अच्छा फ्रॉम बी ही कैन ऑल्सो गो टू ई. ओके ही कैन ऑल्सो गो टू ई एंड फ्रॉम ई ही कैन गो टू एफ. ओके आफ्टर दैट अगेन लेट्स टेक हिम टू बी एंड लेट्स सी इफ ही कैन गो एनीवेयर एल्स. सो ही हैज गॉन टू एफ, ही हैज गॉन टू ई, ही कैन गो टू डी. ओके आफ्टर डी व्हाट ही कैन डू इज ही कैन गो टू सी. ओके एंड देन ही कैन गो टू ई एंड देन ही कैन गो टू एफ. ओके आफ्टर दैट नाउ कैन इफ वी टेक ए टू बी. सो ही हैज गॉन टू एफ, ही हैज गॉन टू ई, ही हैज गॉन टू डी. He cannot go back to A. Okay. So that means he cannot go any more time to B. The next stop cannot be B. So let's take him to D now. Acha, when we take him to D, he has two possibilities. One to C. And in one case, he can go to... Sorry, guys. In one case, he can go to B. Okay. If he goes to C, then he has only one possibility, E and F. But if he goes to B, again, he has a possibility of going to E and then going to F. Or he has the possibility of directly going to F. Okay, so these are the possible routes as of now. Achha, let's see if there is another possible route available. So A, D, B and F is done. A, D, B, E, F is done. A, D, C, E, F is done. Okay, achha, one more thing is there. See, after A to D to C and E, he can also come to B again. Okay, so there is one more route. So A, D, C. Okay, A, D, C. Then he went to E. Then he again came back to B and then went to F. So this is also a possibility. Okay. So now after that, can he go to D and can he change his routes? He has went to D, went to B, B, E, F, B to F. So B is completed. E say he cannot go anywhere. D say C, C say E, 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 B. Okay. All the routes are completed. So this is how we go about the routes. Now let's move towards A to C. Let's see what cases are formed in A to C. So if he goes to C, then he will have the option of going to E or he will have the option for going to D. Okay, chalo, if he went to E, then he has option of going to directly to F or he has the option of going to B and then going to F. Okay, acha, now what else we can have? Acha, when he went to A, C, then D, he can go to B and he can go to F. Or what he can do is he can go to D. After that, he will go to E. He will go to B and then he can go to E and then F. Okay, so these are also the possibilities. Yes, let's see if there is another possibility left. Okay, A to B, A to C, C to E, F, this route also done. Achha, now all the routes are done. So let's count how many routes are there. So 1 route, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. So a total of 11 routes are there. Now, and here there were 3 routes. So the difference is, absolute difference is 11 minus 3. Okay, so 8. Your answer will be 8. So I hope you have understood it well, guys. So the only thing which you have to take care of is ki, see, like you went to B, then consider all the cases for B. B say he can go to E, he can go to F, he can go to D. Now again make cases. So like this you can go and the probability of losing one of the routes, which is very high in general cases, can be reduced a little bit, okay? Because see, whenever there are 11 cases to be made, definitely most of you are going to miss one or two of them. To avoid that, this is the way that you can approach with taking one at a time, going A to B, then from B, checking all the possible options, then going A to D, checking all the possible options, going A to C, checking all the possible options, okay? So this is a way in which you can avoid missing out one or two of the routes. And you will have your accuracy in this kind of sets. These are very easy sets, by the way. So I hope you have understood it well, guys. So thanks for watching the video.